Exactly. Aurelia falling behind is completely useless.
Let's oh my god, he left the Emperor home.
All right, I guess. Whatever. We don't need Brand here. NX are actually deep invading now.
This is a beautiful level one.
Oh, they're going to move around the corner. Sven is going to go back, and he's going to face check.
This feels very... The ward's there, but Sven's...
Where are you going to go?
Exhaust is down. Mithy can't save him, and that'll be first blood. Who gets it? It is a miracle. We are going to watch this one again. This was really nice, actually, from G2.
And this is actually set up by that teleport advantage that they had up there in the top lane. And so they're able to pick off the crit. They almost actually got Steos, but they're not able to actually translate that into a Mountain Dragon.
Pink Ward did get cleared by Smurf after Expect recalled again to get the Phage. And now he's going to get ganked.
Oh, flash in there, but he's going to get stunned after a Cocoon Chain. Very nicely, Expect going to get it turned around. Transcendent Blaze might be enough to save his life. He needs the help, but it is not enough. Elise with the kill.
Steos just got outside of the tower range, didn't go down. Expect using flash and... That'd been double longsword. Probably would have died. Just saying, let's move on. Perk's getting attacked.
There, but Kira's going to jump back in. Lightning Shield still going in, but Kira just bats him out of the way. Blue buff for Perks is kind of creating a little imbalance in that trade.
And they know that Trick actually can't be there for the counter gank or match gank because he was handing off blue to Perks.
Ooh, very nice. Catches the miracle, actually. Licorice moves in. The heal burnt. Mithy in trouble there as Lycaon's going to move back down. The other Q hits from Licorice, and now Mithy is in trouble in the bottom lane.
And not just sit back and let them get the items.
They have stunned it again. It's 2v2 soon, but Trick makes it there first. Kira stunned up there by Perks, I believe, but now Steos is going to keep them out. And they're going to keep trading in. Steos, bit of damage there from the Q. Now has to repel. Get to a pink ward, I believe. Very creative, and Smurf's down here now. Expect hasn't made it in time. The stun's going to move in. Trick does go down, and Perks gets stunned as well. ANX just collapsed first, but Expect going to try and play clean up. Smurf getting greedy. He wants the killer's Perks. Flashes out of the way, and Expect does turn it around for a one-for-one trade.
With the Rise Snare, this is how risky it is for Jace, really. If he goes aggressive, he gets 2 seconds snared. We don't want to watch it. We're going to watch Jace
Kira,
die.
Yeah, going to get soloed out. Trick destroys him as he face checks the Raptors.
What was Kira trying to do without Flash and no one around him?
Raptors, baby.
Either Raptors or ganking. But he probably wanted to try and shock blast the Ryze from the side and then try and jump him.
And shoved in by the Sivir, as that's amazing.
But we haven't seen that decisive shock calling from G2 in this tournament, where like you have like a global advantage and you should just make a play on the other side. Oh. Expect that. He really wants to play aggressive on top, though.
Yeah, they've got Flash's good stun from Smurf. His Trick was coming up, might save him. But here's a couple more from ANX. They bring Licorice and Kira.
Oh, and Trick doesn't know about this.
Oh no, that's bad news, Bears. Oh, he's into them for a bit of style. And now Expect maybe getting himself caught here as well. He does have Flash still. Nice little juke around. He's going to try and take out Smurf, but the ulti's there. Exhaust is down, and Alvis Nox get two. Staying limbo as he...
He's already out of
play
group.
Up to the top. But yeah, relax. He's relaxing. Is there actually? Oh no, don't get 1v1 by a miracle. Licorice there, but can't convert for the rest of the kill. Mithy out warding, and that Ghostblade Lucian, you can see, so tough as Sven to 1v1.
Both supports are up here. Both junglers are here as well. That's going to be a big fight.
They're going for it, actually, but Mithy's not going to make it in. Smurf going to get punted back with the Cocoon. Might have tagged Expect. Mithy with a big pole drive, and Smurf is low, but the ulti gets blocked by Brawny. Expect goes down. ANX outplay again.
Trick used everything right into the wall of Braum, and he didn't manage to kill anyone. Kira is here now just for safety. Will back away. Another skirmish lost by G2. A lot of abilities wasted as well.
Yep. And it looks like Steos now is going to move mid lane.
Goodbye.
And...
Oh, it's a fool. Is it a prank? It was not. It's actually going to go in, but that's a flash force. Perks goes in, wants the big play. Going to wait for Elise to rappel back down. Misses that first Q, but the snare's in there, and Ryze does more than enough damage. He's trying to cut around the Spiderlings. Doing a nice job.
Licorice, oh my god!
In. What a save!
Oh.
That was gorgeous.
Oh. He bought so much time with the Spiderlings blocking, or trying to make the Spiderlings block. And Licorice shows up, and nothing is in favor of G2 right now.
G2 capitalized well.
That was just a free bot lane tower, honestly. They've been working on it for quite some time. Let's see what happens mid. He's not really going anywhere.
Good collapse here. Steos just can't get out of this one. No dancing around. As Kira's going to fire out where he can, but who they want to give it to? I think they're going to donate to Perks, but Trick autos and steals it away.
Trick says, I've seen this before, so.
Not waiting this time.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jiju can just kind of hover around here because Xpect will take that top tower and he can just TP down for a fight. As long as Jiju does not get hard engaged or surprised by the cannon.
What did you say? Smurf goes in, but he gets exhausted. Damage is there. But Kira actually flashes on his Venom, forcing him away for now. Perk down here as well. Damage in the front side is nice from the Ryzen. Here comes Xpect. Gonna play cleanup. Ulti is not quite enough. Wants one, doesn't get it as the Repel moves down. And a Miracle's gonna kite it out, but Kira goes down to Perks. ANX trying to run their way out because G2 are now on the offensive. Xpect takes out Stayoff. That's two for nothing so far.
And that was a huge win for G2. The timing of the exhaust by Mythy was absolutely clutch for turning that team fight right now. And the problem is, oh, and a Miracle is probably going to go down here too.
From Mythy. Finds him and there's another one.
To Aurelia.
To a Ghostblade AD carry who didn't even complete his Black Cleaver yet. I feel like that's kind of unfair.
Yeah, it is pretty unfair.
Ooh, that was cute.
Although the Black Cleaver does have synergy with their mid laner. Jace will get a lot of power from that. But then the question comes, what do you do at four or five items when Aurelia, Graves, and Sivir all have QSS?
Ooh.
You cry, I guess?
I mean, this is a little bit sad time. So Smurf pops the ulti, but blown up again as expected. Just takes him out with a Blade Surge. Might even go for it, but G2 instead will just fall back to the Drake, it seems. He's got a Dust Blade. So he's like, you know what? I don't need mana, I just need one combo. Better take it as Squishy as Mythy, nice pulverize to protect his team, but ulti can attack and pops his in response. And G2 gonna waddle on out. Oh, Perks maybe with a catch. That's big damage. Two items there for the Ryze ulti. Oh, that's it! Perks! Huge play!
It's about to be Trick again. This is so aggressive. Dashing forward, but this time, they actually get a kill. They have zero vision of this, and they're not even moving yet. Now they actually react.
Yep, the jungler is dead, and with that Mountain Drake, this Baron is being shredded so quickly, and now they're going to recall, and Ryze is about to get a lot of damage and a lot of effective HP off of that Seraph's Embrace. So if they couldn't deal with G2 before, what are they going to do now when Ryze basically just got like two items?
Problem is G2, they keep pushing. Tower's down to 50%. It's going to drop.
Crit can only block so much, can't block enough for that turret to stay alive. Xpect's gonna take this as well, and Perks is here, so Smurf might just get jumped on. G2 though, they want a bit more, they're gonna try and take this in. If Stayoff looks for the cocoon, doesn't find it. The crit moving forward as well, does have the ulti. Does he dare pull the trigger? Trick does get himself out of the way, and now it's 2v2 top. Perks is so strong as well.
So there is a macro play which would just completely asphyxiate ANX, yep. And they're not making use of it.
Pretty unconventional one, but certainly a cool option, and that's sort of the story right now. G2 have everything available to them. In fact, Perks is going to go in. Kira almost going to go through, and now Perks wants it more! Looking for the crit, going to try and find it. Dustbird's fucking everywhere. Oh, that's awkward. ANX trying to punish, but not going to happen. Trick gets cocooned, but Mithy going to save the day. And Xpect's in the backline, going to get one. Going to look to hop down and try and get another. Aurelia goes ballistic in the team fight, and G2 might just clean house here.
And it's definitely looking like that with that minion wave up there in top lane, this is probably going to be the final push. Death timer's too high, no ultimate up on a Miracle, so it's not like Lucian's going to be able to try to push this wave back. And it looks like G2 keeping CLG and the Rocks Tigers' hopes alive to still secure that first place seed in Group A.
Very, very spicy game, but G2 will take it. ANX will pick up another loss. G2, the only winner of the tournament. They played spoiler, though. And all of a sudden, our last game is very interesting.